once we understand that you are going to carry out the actions of Jannah, people of Jannah, or carry out the actions of people of Hellfire, it shows us that in our life right now, mashallah, four of you are sitting here in the masjid. Can I say jazman, 100%, without any doubt, you are people of Jannah? This hadith is telling us, no, you cannot. Because it's quite possible, 5 years down the line, may Allah protect all of you and protect your iman and make you steadfast on Islam and towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it is possible, potentially it is possible, 5 years from now, somebody is going to lose out on his opportunity and start doing bad deeds. Right? Similarly, apply the opposite as well. When you walk outside, right, there's a bar there and everything. You see a redneck guy who's swearing at you and everything, right? And smelling of booze and everything. Can you jazman 100% say this is the person of hellfire? You cannot. You cannot. And that tells you in your heart that you cannot hate anyone like that. Right? You cannot hate anyone because tomorrow he may say the shahada 5 breaths away from his death when he's not in sakarat. And he may enter and completely his amal will be at zero, much better than us with so many sins, right? It's quite possible. So we don't know. This is why this statement comes: think everyone as better than you. Some people are going to be better than you filhal, in this time right now, and others might be better than you fil ma'al, in what's going to happen in the end. Who knows what my last breath is going to bring? May Allah save my iman. Because who knows at that time, what will I be contemplating? Everybody may be thinking, mashallah, big sheikh, big mufti, big this and everything. And in my mind, I might have, may Allah protect, so many doubts about Allah that I may not be a Muslim. May Allah protect. It can happen. Right? We have examples in history of these things, which Allah has opened up to us. So always seek protection from Allah, that Allah has given us guidance. May Allah keep us on guidance. This is why the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was with regards to the hidayah. Oh Allah, once you have guided us, do not mislead us. Do not lead us towards misguidance at all. Right? Always keep on asking this. This is why you keep on making the dua. Ya muqallib al qulub, ya muqallib al qulub, qallib. Sorry, what is it? Sabbit qalbi ala dinik. Ya musarraf al qulub, sabbit amali ala ita'atik. I believe those are the words. Right? So these duas are to be repeated and besought. Keep on asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if you don't know the Arabic words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need language. Cry out to Him, Ya Allah, I need protection and I need guidance in this. Keep on taking me. So let me not move away from the hidayah and move into misguidance. This will be the final abode for us.